Now we can start on our first coding step. To handle the image crossfades, we will use the jQuery FadeOut method. This will require selecting two img elements, one for fading out and one for fading over. Our plan for selecting the FadeOut img element is to use the CSS active class. And for selecting the fade over img element, we will use the jQuery CSS and next methods. Let's get started with the crossfade code. Copy the code in snippet 1, insert as line 6 in the crossfade JS file. We will always fade out the img element having the active class. In line 7, we create a jQuery object variable for it. Then we simply call the jQuery fadeout method using a duration of 1.5 seconds. Refresh, open the elements panel, click the next button one time. The fadeout method animates the opacity CSS property using the style attribute. Then, when completed, the display property is set to none, also using the style attribute. Repeat clicking the next button. Nothing appears to happen. That is because the img active class element is now hidden. So there's nothing for jQuery to fade out. Did you notice which img element appeared after the fade out completed? It was the third. Both the second and third have a z-index value of auto. This leaves it up to the web browser to choose the order. So we need to choose the next img element. We have our completed lines in snippet 2. Paste on line 8 of the crossfade JS file. Line 9 uses the jQuery next method. It lets us select the next sibling for our img active class element. On line 11, we use the jQuery CSS method to set the sibling's z-index property. The value we are using is 2. This is 1 below the z-index for the active class. We have that set to 3 in the crossfade CSS file. This sets up the fadeout method on line 13 to fade out the image active class element over its next sibling. Refresh. The first img element's z-index is 3. The second is auto. Now click the next button once. The second img element z-index becomes 2. And the first img element's display value becomes none. Next, we need to move the active class from the faded out img element to the next img element. That completes the first part of our coding. We saw how to use the jQuery fadeout method to crossfade two images. We used the CSS active class to identify the fadeout image. To select the fadeover image, we used the jQuery CSS and next methods. Now we can start on the code to cycle the fadeout and fadeover images for successive crossfades.